Looking for quick, easy fall activities to do with your toddler or preschooler? I'm sharing seven fall-themed activities that range from no mess to super messy sensory learning experiences using activities you already have probably in your home or around your home. If you're looking for strictly no mess fall activities, I shared 10 of those last year, which I will link in the description box below. And if you're new here, my name is Rachel from The Confused Mom. Welcome to my channel. I share toddler activities, Montessori tips and toy reviews, so make sure to hit that notification and subscribe button so you don't miss any of the videos coming up. And before we jump into the activities, I just wanted to say each of these activities has a blog post for it, which I will link in the description box below in case you need to go back, reference anything. All right, now let's jump into it. First of all, activity that we are going to do is a fall Montessori inspired glue box. In one of our Love Every Play Kits, you saw my daughter was absolutely obsessed with the Montessori glue and paste box, and I thought fall was the perfect opportunity to enhance this activity. So what I did was I got this printout, which I will also link in the description box below for you guys, of just a barren tree. And then her and I went on a nature walk one morning, and we collected a ton of foliage that had fallen. Rocks, seeds, twigs, and leaves. That's going to be really important because we use a lot of that foliage from a lot of the activities in this video. Once we got home, I went ahead, gave her the barren tree, gave her a little ramekin of glue and her glue brush, and I gave her some of the leaves. Now, here's a tip. For younger toddlers, I would highly recommend using flatter leaves. Some of the leaves that have a little bit more wave or curve to them can be harder for them to glue down, and I noticed my daughter would get frustrated when those curvier leaves weren't staying, and she'd ask for my help. So if your toddler is starting to lose interest in this, definitely sort out some flat leaves. Well, once we got that troubleshooted, she had an absolute blast with it. And how you could enhance this activity if you have an older toddler or a preschooler is by numbering the tree branches and numbering a few of the leaves and making it a matching game in addition to the glue paste activity. As far as messiness of that activity goes, it was pretty low mess, and it took me literally 1 minute to set up, 1 minute to clean up, again, aside from the nature walk collecting all those other items, which we're gonna use for a lot of other activities in this video. The next fall-themed activity is going to be fall sticky shapes. Once again, I have a printout for you guys. I will link below. You guys can obviously make your own too. And all you're gonna do is get a pack of circle stickers, and you want the colors of the circle stickers to match the colors of your shape printout. So I will leave a link to the specific ones I purchased below. And really simply, your little one is going to take off the circle sticker and place it on the outline of the fall shape. Now for younger toddlers, you may just want them to get the color inside. So like the orange pumpkin, just get the orange stickers inside the orange pumpkin. As they get older, you want them to trace the line of the exterior of the pumpkin. And then if you wanted to even enhance this a little bit more, again, you could always number the shapes, number the stickers, kind of make it like a paint by number type thing. You can get that specific sticker in place on the pumpkin or letter. She had so much fun with this. She was so proud of her work. I mean, what toddler doesn't love stickers? Overall, this is very low mess, and I highly, highly recommend this one. And again, the printouts for it are linked in the description box below. The next activity is just a really simple fall Montessori inspired sorting activity. So going back to that foliage we collected earlier, I went ahead, set up three different bins, one for leaves, one for twigs, and one for rocks. I also went ahead and printed out pictures so I could label each bin. While that is not necessary at all, you could also just show your toddler by putting the first item in each bin and showing them where it goes. Super simple. From there, I just gave her all the stuff we collected and let her sort it. And she had so much fun doing this. Her baby brother was watching and she was showing him what she was doing. It was a really great opportunity for her to work on some language stuff, and she had a blast. For younger toddlers, you may want to only give them two things at once. So just leaves and twigs to start. As they get older, you can introduce leaves, twigs, rocks, acorns, pine cones, whatever you collected. You can add more categories to it. And then for older kids, like I would say 5, 6, What I would say is have a miscellaneous bin and allow them to really problem solve and troubleshoot. This doesn't go in any of these places. Where should I put it? Where do outliers go? Versus having a specific spot for them to easily categorize things. I wouldn't suggest that. I had done that with my 2.5-year-old. She ended up putting all of the seeds in with the rocks. She did not like the fact that they didn't have a spot to go. So keep in mind the Montessori sensitive period for order. If your child is in that, I would definitely make sure every item has a home. The next fall activity is a little fall inspired sensory bin. So depending on the level of mess you like, you can use a few different bases here. You could use dirt, you could use sand, you could even use foam. I will link how to make foam in the description box below as well. Or you can do Play-Doh, which is what we did here, and I will link how to make it in the description box below. You'll also use some of the fall foliage that you collected earlier, and then any scoopers or jars. I love this little sensory box. It comes with these brushes, scoopers, and little bowls to set everything up in. And really simple, you'll pour in your base, and then once again, you'll use those fall foliage items you collected earlier for a sensory experience. There's no need to model anything here. Just give it to your child and let them explore freely and see what they come up with. My daughter initially was quite skeptical with this activity. Like I mentioned, she is definitely in the Montessori sensitive period for order. She wanted all the rocks to stay where they were and all the pine cones to stay where they were, but I left it out for her, and over the course of a week, she engaged with it every single day. It was one of those things where I just needed to leave it and get out of the room, and all of a sudden she started to do all sorts of different things with it. She would make little rock mounds out of the Play-Doh and stick the pine cones and the rocks in. She had a lot of fun just putting things in and out of the Play-Doh and that texture of everything, and I mean, it ended up providing hours of entertainment for her, so that was a huge win for us. The next fall activity is a fall oobleck tray. And if you've never heard of oobleck before, it is a non-Newtonian fluid, which sounds fancy, but all it means is that it acts both like a solid when pressure is applied and like a liquid when no pressure is applied. It is so easy to make. It is the original slime. All you need is 2 cups of cornstarch to 1 cup of water. That's it. Now I will say this is definitely the messiest activity of everything, because when your toddler uses force, it will harden, but then as they lift their hands out of it, it will melt away like a liquid. So we know how toddlers can kind of flail their hands. You will probably get a lot of this on your floor, on your countertops, wherever you're doing this. So I might suggest doing it outside. But if you do it inside, it is really easy to clean because, again, it's just cornstarch and water. Totally taste safe for those kids that like to taste things or put things in their mouth. And to clean it, all you do is rinse off with hot water. But there's also another way to clean it, which we'll talk about in a moment. Once again, I used those fall foliage items. I used some leaves, which held up really well in the mixture, and we used some rocks with this, and I gave her a spoon. Other way to clean oobleck, and the secondary part of this activity, if you choose to do it, is let it dry out overnight. When it dries out, it fully hardens, and then your toddler or preschooler can break it up and excavate the items left behind. And let me tell you, she had an absolute blast with that. She has been doing that for the last 5 days, pulling out the rocks, getting giant chunks of the oobleck out, and being like, this is a fishy. Now this is a school bus, and kind of coming up with all these little creative scenarios with it. 2 ways to clean: rinse with hot water. Definitely let your sink run for a few extra minutes after you pour everything down there, letting it dry out and just kind of cracking it and then tossing that in the garbage. So either way, easy to clean, doesn't stain clothes. I have a full blog post on how to make oobleck if you need to go back to any of those tips. Next fall activity is fall leaf painting, and really simple. You're going to once again use those leaves you collected and give your toddler some paint and let them use the leaves as paintbrushes. And then also give them just some different textures. If you can find leaves that maybe are like more pine needly, and then leaves that are more round, it gives them opportunity to see that they make different types of strokes. This is like a moderate mess activity. My daughter doesn't tend to get a lot of paint on her anymore. And the next activity not only provides that fine motor skill refinement like we've been doing, but it also gives you a really nice gross motor opportunity, and that is the apple tree forest. So what you're gonna do is is you're going to collect any paper towel rolls or toilet paper rolls, and you're also going to get a bag of red and green apples, or just red apples or just green apples, whatever. And what you're going to do is you're going to have your child stack the apple on top of the cardboard rolls to make little apple trees. This alone can be an activity for younger toddlers. It's kind of like a little lesson in engineering. But if your kid is a little bit older, you can have them set up the apple trees around kind of a larger space, like across their play mat, and then challenge them to run through the apple tree forest without knocking any over. So again, you may have to adapt this and tweak it to meet your child where they're at. And then, of course, you may need to model running through the forest for them. They may not understand what it is you're trying to do right away. So definitely just kind of watch your kids, see how they engage it with it. Don't try to push them, but you would be surprised. Another nice thing, if you are trying to have them run through the forest and it's just not really working, they're not really understanding the idea of weaving, you could set up all green apples on one side of the room and all red apples on the other side and just call back and forth the color. So then they would run over to the green apple tree forest, and then they run over to the red apple tree forest, and do it that way too, to really get that gross motor and burn some of that little kid energy off. I love this activity because it takes 1 minute to set up, 1 minute to clean up. It's super easy, super fun. Kept my kid engaged for quite a while. She wanted to set it up and play with it for a few days. Uses all the things already in your house, which is a nice little win. Make sure to hit that notification and subscribe button so that you don't miss my Halloween toddler activities video or my toy reviews and gift guides coming up for the holidays to make shopping a lot easier. In the meantime, feel free to go back, check out my last year No Mess Fall Toddler Activities, as well as my Montessori gift guide for 1 to 2 year olds. If you use any of these activities with your little one, I would love to see it. Be sure to tag me on Instagram @TheConfusedMillennial. And until next time, have a good one.